Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. Today I'm coming to share with you hopefully very quick tutorial how you can create these cutie beauties small journals. They are made based for these journals. It's made from 12 by 12 inches size of designed paper, and they are kind of easy, I think. I believe it depends how much decorations you want to put there. I changed every single one. I've got loads of openings, loads of pockets, loads of these funny things, those tags where you can open those pages, and you've got pockets here and pocket here. I like to play with all these papers, but you can do it simple, and I think it will be beautiful project for maybe for craft bazaars. Now it's coming so many great holidays, so I think you can create really beautiful beautiful journal from one sheet of 12 by 12. Yeah, I'm sorry. So today I think I'm gonna show you very quickly all of them. This is made using Tim Holtz. I think this is French industry collection used for this journal, and it's made out of one sheet as well. It has loads of pockets. Here is magnetic. Here is that frame I told you in the previous video, so you can slide photography behind. Here I've got just small ephemera, but all these corners are like holding picture. It's again made from that 12 by 12. Here is pocket. This pocket I've got on every single one. Here I've got upside down pocket where you can slide out your ephemeras. Here I've got teeny mini journal with also embellishments and layouts and all kind of beauties using Tim Holtz photographies, Tim Holtz ephemeras. So this is teeny mini journal here. All my journals, those mini journals, has large pocket on the back side. Here we've got this type of pocket, and here is opening with writing space. I will go back to this one as well. Here we've got pocket. This can be open like this, and here we've got pocket and also writing space and large pocket we've got here. I'm gonna put it aside. I'm gonna close it everything later. I'm gonna one more show you this one. It has same style window pocket here, maybe for some photography. Here, window pocket. Oh, sorry. Window pocket here. Another pocket behind. Pocket here. Then open. We've got pocket here, pocket here. This is magnetic. This I showed you. Here is large pocket. This can be open like this. So there is space for journaling. We've got pocket here with stamping and with small, it's like envelope or folder for this teeny meeny beautiful photography. I love these photographies with children because they always make me so, so happy. Here we've got normal large envelope pocket or coin pocket. Oh, sorry for my shadow. And here we've got small journal with loads of papers, designed papers, decorative papers. So this is small journal here, and again pocket on that back side. And then I've got those two. These are Christmas journals. Here I used elastic band like a closure, and it's open like this. And we've got again window pocket here. I have to do it left hand because we've got there my light switch on. Here we've got like slide pocket. First I thought that I'm gonna use this one like a closure, but I place it two up, so I will have to bund this one and it will be not too good to slide it behind. But you can use something like this, like a closure. Just put it a little bit lower and then you can slide your top page behind that. I'm gonna try to do it today in small tutorial. It open like this. Here I've got, I'm gonna turn it over. Here I've got large piece of 12 by 12 and its pocket here. And then we've got pocket here. I used loads of dies. Many of my dies are X-Cut. Some of these dies are Tonic Studio. Here we've got pocket. Here we've got pocket. And another pocket is here. I forgot to put there something. Here we've got magnetic closure. With this... I forgot the name of these. Gloves. I know, it's not gloves. Mint, I think it's mint, call it mint. And we've got journaling space here. It's nice journaling space here. When we open it, we've got pocket here for a small tag. Like this. Behind, we've got journaling space here. When you open it, we've got beautiful picture with these kids. And journaling here, pocket, and here is pocket, and here is pocket, behind. And when you open it, we've got beautiful large pocket here. Like this, with ephemeras inside. Small pocket, it's here. Like this, I have to... My other hand... Oh, it's not! Oh, I thought that I made pocket there. Did I? I did. Yes, I did. Look at me. It's because I'm using left hand. So it's a small pocket here. And we've got small beautiful journal here with stamping. And in last video I forgot to show you my new stamping tool. I totally adore that tool because, as I said, I've been pretty bad with stamping. I always had those shadows around and those dirty shades around. I didn't stamp properly. That was drive me crazy. But now I've got brilliant stamping tool. So I actually enjoy that stamping process and to create my layouts and book pages, not book pages, background pages. And here is another Christmas. It's again a closure here on the bottom like this. Here I used its triple layout of this beautiful die. I will wrote down as much as I know. Most of my dies are from the past, so for some of my dies I don't have a name, but I know this one I have got somewhere package, so I can write down where from it is. So which die I will know where from I've got them, or branch where from I've got them. I will write it down in the description below. So when we open it, we've got pocket here with those two teeny mini tags. It's like Bethlehem. It's in this pocket. We've got here beautiful snowman. We've got slide pocket here. We've got again, this is slide pocket or spot. Maybe for some photography. This is again magnetic. I put magnet in one of these Christmas bulbs. And it's open like this. Here is space for photography. Here, journaling page. We've got pocket here. Small layout from dies. We've got here journaling page. No, journaling spot like this. And we've got pocket here. With small tags like this. And also we've got pocket here with some tag and ephemera. And when we open it, it's so many opening. We've got like coin envelope, I think it's called coin envelope, with small layout of my dice and some ephemeras. And here journaling section with pages, pages, pages. and with here I stamped and embossed also. I'm telling you, I really enjoying it. And we've got pocket here, pocket here. So this is Christmas theme. And I've got one which I create from Atlas book. So you can also enjoy this process from Atlas book. Just remember, Atlas books mostly, even Atlas books which are very big, which this one was, they don't have 12 by 12. They've got mostly 10 or 10 and a half inches. So you have to resize your scoring, but it can be possible to create. Here I used maps like my base. I glued together two pages from my Atlas book, and I create this cute small teeny tiny travel journal. It has pocket here. This is just like decoration. It has pocket here for these two tags with charms. It has opening here. And it has pocket here, and this, here is just journaling section, maybe space for photography. It has like file folder or folder pocket here. Here it has small journal with so many pockets. I forgot to put there some tags and ephemeras, I will have to. And this is magnetic again. Here I've got magnet. And when you open it, we've got like writing section, and it's also a pocket here. I will have to add all these tags I forgot. And as you can see, again, my stamping, yay! It has slide pocket here. I need something. A slide spot like this, so you can slide there some notes. And we've got journaling section here, and this is also like file folder pocket or a folder pocket. So this is very teeny meeny tiny journal made out of Atlas book. So today I'm gonna show you how you can create it that base. Hopefully I will show you how you can put there some pockets and writing space. I prepared a little bit for that job here. I'm gonna do again a Christmas theme, so I choose this paper. It is from bear with me, this collection, Mix and Match Pretty Red Classics. And these papers are really brilliant. They are very heavy. It's a really brilliant, good cardstock, very heavy, very sturdy. I think it's 300 grammage, really good quality cardstock. And they are pretty good, really nice designs. Mostly in that vintage style, which I really like. I'm mostly creating vintage style journals, but I will show you one more. And I'm gonna try to switch on one more of my lights, just bear with me, and I will be back. I've got ready my scoring board. Here I've got double-sided paper from the collection I showed you. I will show you also how you can do it from a single side, how to choose. If you don't have 12 by 12 paper, two book pages, glued them to some large piece of paper and cut out 12 by 12 by 12. Why is it so hard for me to say that? From this size of paper, this large one. And now, what are we gonna score? First score line will be 3.5 inches down. All that way down. Make nice scoring line. Do not press too much, but make really nice, beautiful scoring line. When I will show you on that one side printed paper, I will also draw it down to make sure that you will see that properly. First scoring line, it's 3.5 inches. Second, it's 4 inches. That next line will be 8 inches. And next line, 8.5 inches. These are our first lines. And also remember, these lines are for like this journal. It's like this. So what will be here on the top will be here. Then turn it like this and make two scoring lines. First will be, bear with me, 3 inches. Stay 3 inches. And that next one will be 9 inches. Do not get scared. Now it's coming for scissors. I'm gonna turn it to this way because here I can see better way. Hopefully you will see those score lines. I'm gonna take my distress tool and I'm gonna distress a little bit these score lines so you will see better what I'm gonna cut out. I'm gonna be right back. So I distress it a little bit so you can see better way now my scoring lines. And now what you're gonna cut, all these places are totally similar, so even if you will grab it like this, just remember if you've got some pattern, not like this, but with maybe some beautiful face here and you wanna have that face on your cover, just remember to score it properly. What you're gonna cut, it's this first line, like this. This last line, like this. Oops. And same way from that opposite side. Here first and last. And I will explain why really soon. Now grab your scoring board again. I'm gonna fold these inside, also these inside, so here we started when we've got open full page, we scored 3.5, 4, 8, and 8.5. When we turn it, we are in this position. I'm gonna flop it over because I made my scoring lines from here. So I'm gonna fold it inside to make sure you will see that shape. Like this. Oops. Sit. Here we've got those two score lines. Two score lines. And here is just one on 3 and on 9. So now what you need to score, it's 2.5. Make score line on this piece and same, it will be 1/2 inch here. Here we've got 9 inches score line, so here it will be 9.5 and score. And I'm gonna show you why. Flip it over. I'm gonna distress a little bit so you can see what I mean. Here we've got like small squares. We're gonna cut them out like this and like, oops, this. Try to cut them out nicely because you can make actually embellishment. I'm gonna cut it from inside because it makes nicer cut. If I will hold everything from here, it will make like this. I'm gonna fold these edges. Try to cut them nicely because you've got actually square, proper square. If you score properly, you will have nice square piece. And here in this journal, I use them like my embellishment here, like my stopper. These are those squares from these corners. So cut them on all these pieces. I'm gonna do it on that other side as well. I know now I am a little bit chaotic, but don't worry, I will be not. Again, cut nicely. Cut and hey. You know, when I'm taking video, my hands are probably shaking too much. Cut. And here I'm gonna flip it over because I'm making better cuts like from this way. I'm not sure why. I can't cut behind. I'm not sure why. I think it's similar. It's totally same, but I need to see my score. So I'm cutting better way. Like this. And cut. Again. I'm gonna flip it over again. I'm sorry for this flipping, flopping. And cut. Pardon me. So we've got our four square pieces which you can use like your embellishment. And now what we created. This is... I'm gonna fold it. How my score lines are. I'm gonna fold these, how these score lines are. And what we've got here, it's our base for 6x4 pocket journal. These are side covers. This is top. And this is bottom. And as you can see, they are not matching together. It's a huge gap between them. So, that's why I left these edges here. These flops. Because you can actually add to these flops another pockets. Which will make layout here. And you can use this like your closure. If you will turn it inside. You will have base for your window pocket. Like I've got here, as you can see, it's these sides are holding my window pocket and it makes beautiful space all on all this pocket. So I'm gonna put this scoring board on the side. I'm gonna first the distress. Oh, no, not yet. Not yet. I'm gonna show you. Also, if you will want to use one side paper, before you're going to do your scoring lines, choose what you want to have on the top. I think all of you knows when I'm making score line here, then I have to fold it inside. Not like this, but inside. Because my scoring tool, this bone folder, it's making like a gap inside. I don't know how to explain it, but I think you know. Here it's going up and here is going inside. So where you've got it inside, then you actually fold it opposite way. Not what I thought at the first, that here is going inside, so I'm gonna fold it this way, and then my paper mostly cracked. It was ripped off and it didn't hold properly. I'm not sure why it works this way. Maybe some fibers inside are already moved and they are holding properly. So always when you've got your score line in, then you fold opposite way. So before you're gonna start to score one side paper, choose what you wanna have on the top as your cover. If I will have this print inside of my journal, I'm gonna score like this. I'm gonna score these lines here. I'm gonna score here 3.5, here 4, here 8, and 8.5. I'm gonna take again the pencil and I'm gonna I'm not gonna show you. Will I? Will I? Come on, Evie, you can do it. Here is 3.5. Here is, my writing is terrible. Here is 4 inches. Here 8. 8 inches. I hope it's right. And 8.5 inches here. 8.5 inch. Like this. Then I'm gonna flip it like this and I'm gonna score. Once again, 3. And 9. I'm gonna draw it down. Here is 3 inch. Sorry, it's those waves underneath. They are disturbing my writing. Here, 3 and 9. Then I'm gonna cut first. Like this. Last, like this, turn it first, like this, last, like this, then these sides, to make it easy for me to see that better, I'm gonna turn inside. And here we're gonna score 1/2 inch on sides, which means here I've got 3, so then it will be 2.5, and you can drive from the top, and here you are sure that you will have 1/2 inch. That's why I'm folding those sides inside, because then I can go in that line, and I know actually that I'm right. Here it will be, here is 9 inches, so here it will be 9.5, and I should go. Oops, do not move. 9.5. I'm gonna take my pencil. Here it's, I'm gonna flip it over because I am upside down. But even if you will do it upside down, with this scoring lines, you are always right, because all these sides are totally similar. Similar. Oh, I'm sorry. Good. Huge problem to speak today. 9.5 here. So what we've got, it's this one. Here you can see. Oops, like this. 3.5, 4, 8, and 8.5, and here we've got 3 and 9, all size, and 2.5 and 9.5. And when you've got that one side paper, now you can see on the top I will have white paper, which I am able to decorate again. Here we need to cut those small pieces. Do not forget, because then these edges will make base for your pockets. I'm not gonna cut it now, it will be too long. I'm gonna prepare my table and I will try to somehow finish that journal. So I distressed all my edges on both sides to make it look vintage. This is my bottom of that journal, this will be top of that journal, these are those sides. And I already prepared small pieces which I would like to add to this journal. So hopefully I can show you something. So what I chose here, I would like to extend this bottom pocket. And I'm gonna use this like inside pocket. I can also make it this like outside pocket. It depends how you will fold these edges. If you will fold them inside, you're gonna build pocket outside. Then what you need, because this inside piece, it's 6 by 4 inches. What you're gonna need, it's 4 inches wide, and it's good 6 inches long piece. Then make a score line 1/2 inch from the bottom, fold it, and cut these notches to make sure that it will get nicely under these edges, just slide it, glue it underneath, then glue this on those folded edges, and you've got beautiful pocket like this. But I would like to have this one like inside pocket, so I'm gonna fold them outside. I'm gonna also cut small notches here to make sure that that pocket will be nice. Just small notches here on the bottom, those corners, just shape it a little bit. So this is top of my journal. Here I've got, this was 6 inches tall and 4 inches deep. Here I made score line half an inch. And here I use, this is Martha Stewart Puncher. I've got it from my very amazing friend from America, from Evie. Evie, thank you so much. I'm gonna fly to my country next week to celebrate my daddy's birthday. So I'm gonna give him those, I forgot again name of that. You know what I mean, what you sent me from those animals, and I hope he will love that. I believe he will love that. So this is Martha Stewart Punch what I used here on the top. So now what I'm gonna do, I need to slide to glue this piece here on the bottom, just match it with that edge, with that fold edge, like this, glue it down like this, then glue these, not glued, fold these ends and glued them to that top piece. And I will have beautiful, beautiful pocket. But because in this journal I would like to use the closure I showed you here, like slide this top top flop, I would like to slide behind. So I already prepared this one. I need to find my strips of thread. I've got somewhere here. I will find them and I'm gonna show you how you can fit it all together. I found it. Yay! This, what is it? It's not yarn. It's not thread. Trim. This is actually recycling. I hope I will say that right. Between two rooms sometimes can be like blinders from trims. It's one next to each other, and my neighbors had this one from those golden threads between living room and a hallway, and they didn't like it anymore, so they gave me all that blinder. I hope it's blinder, maybe it called it somehow different, but hopefully you know what I mean. So I'm recycling here. It's brilliant. It's kind of goldy. And for Christmas time, it's the wonderful, wonderful thing. So one thing for recycling, if you will know someone who've got this one, just go there and take it. So I found it. And before I will manage this one, I have to fix my top closure. Here I would like to have these corners, so I'm gonna use, this is X-cut, I think it's called X-cut corner punch. This is L size. I'm gonna show you how large. You can make corners, beautiful corners like this, and if you will place your paper from this side to this gap, come on, go there, to this gap, like this, you can make these like ticket cuts. Ticket cuts. So I'm gonna use this one. And I'm always taking this screw, like my measurement, that make it nice and even. Where are my scissors? I lost my scissors. Oh, no. Right here. I'm gonna cut these pieces a little bit down. And from here as well, kind of even, like this. So now I have holding sides for my frame. So I'm gonna glue down this frame on the top. Make sure, if you wanna use some window frame, make sure you're not gonna glue it on these score lines, because this will be your closure. So glue it just above those score lines, maybe like this. What I'm using here, they are pre-made. I'm lazy. These are Ladedag, it's name of company. And these inside, it's 4 self-adhesive photo booth frames. I hope you can see that. Made in China. Yeah, Ladedag. These frames and that piece of acetate. It's another recycling. Gonna show you. I've got new blinders right there. They are vertical blinders and they came in this package. Oops, it's too long, very long packaging material. So I save it and now I'm always cutting pieces like this and I'm recycling these pieces for my craft. So this is another recycling tip where you can find your acetate pieces. They are brilliant for photo frames. So I'm gonna glue it down. Where is my glue? Oh, it's here. I'm using this. It's Anita's Tacky Glue, PVA glue. It's really good glue. It's glue beautifully. It dries fast. And I'm very satisfied with this glue. I just need to use pin inside. Because when I had that top cover on there, mostly was leaking out, but because I think I cut large space from the top, I think it was my mistake that I cut there too much from the top. So glue it down like this. I hope I didn't make mistake. I also prepared somewhere here. I prepared the top piece I would like to have on the top. Of course, top piece on the top. I'm gonna close these to pretend that I've got some journal inside. And when I will close that, where is my... Here is the book page. Not book page, that pocket page. I'm gonna slide it behind. I'm not gonna glue it yet because I would like to have that closure. And I think... like this, it will be beautiful. Maybe I will put there some lace. Let me think. We'll come back. So we're gonna make our layout. I've got here prepared my top of my journal. I decide to leave it like it is now, without any embellishment underneath, without any lace, because I'm not sure. It didn't went to way I wanted those laces I chose. So I'm gonna glue it down here, and as you can see, I've got three layouts. Here is this image, underneath it's book page, which is a little bit longer than is this image, and here I've got again, same size like is that image, I've got this designed paper, and it's kind of nicely matching that background here. It's going beautifully, those designs together. And I was thinking I'm gonna make pocket here as well. So I'm gonna glue down this image just on these sides. And how to put glue, if you are not sure, I'm always placing that image I want to glue down upside down to make sure I will do not put glue too much where I don't wanna glue it. So here I can see where it's ending, that pocket I will have there. So I know where to put glue properly. I'm gonna put my glue on this side. Here I can put a little bit more glue because I don't mind if that pocket will be not too deep. So here and here. I'm gonna glue it down. Now I scared myself that I'm putting glue on that opposite side. Make sure you're holding your image right way. I'm gonna glue down my image like this. Fold it down. Oh, no, don't move. Don't move, please, don't move. See? Like this. Okay. I think. Oh my. because I'm taking video, I'm so, so bad. If you're not sure, just flip it over. Make sure you've got this nicely on both sides. I think this is good enough. And now how to fit this piece. I'm gonna slide it in to make sure it will be on position when it will be on the end. And I think I will put this piece right here. So first, this trim can be here. I will remember the position of my trim, and I think on this position, in this position, it will be nice. So now I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna use double-sided tape, just small pieces of double-sided tape to hold these trims for now. Just, oops, come here. Oh, it's like with piece of bread with butter, it's always flipping with that butter pin, butter side down. So I'm gonna glue it here. And opposite side will be here. Like this. I'm gonna take off these pieces. Oops, not upside down, Evie, not upside down. I think here we have middle. Place it in middle and now glue this piece. Because I've got the double-sided tape. Hopefully. Yes, I guess so. I'm gonna put them a little bit more together, like this. Yeah, I guess. Like this, and same way here. Like this, and like this. Oh, hold, hold. Now I will put here just piece of book page, old book page, just small strips of book page to hold these pieces and make sure that it will not fall down. So I'm gonna glue it to hold it where it's supposed to be, like this. Same way on that other side. You don't have to. If you got good glue, just put there a bit of glue and glue it down with glue, with liquid glue. Maybe some fabric glue, but this way I'm gonna glue it mine. Like this, I'm gonna cut these strips out. Make sure that they will be not on the way in my pocket. Because all this will be in the pocket. I'm gonna use to make sure if something, I'm making vintage journal, and if something, hopefully these pieces will not disturb that view of my pocket. And now I'm gonna glue it inside. In that journal. I'm gonna put glue here on that score edge. I'm gonna slide this piece inside. match that with the bottom part of my box like this. Let it dry, and then I'm gonna put glue here. Hopefully I didn't place it too much far from that pocket. I will see. If yes, I will have to use some embellishment and embellish that. Oh no, stay there. And I'm gonna glue these inside. Ah, good. It's covering everything. And we've got pocket here. Maybe I should place there a little bit more glue. No, it's good. We've got pocket here. And we will have closure here for original. It will look like this. Here you can put some pearls or some embellishment. Here I would like to have frame for some picture. So I'm gonna use this one. It's X-Cut die. This, it collects I love you. Here is a name of the die. I don't wanna put there any glare. I hope you can see that. Here is I love you, and here is XCU503388. There is this die. I love you in so many ways, and there is that frame. So I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna put glue just on these edges to make sure I can still use those small squares like a holder for photo or for some ephemera. Just on these edges, put glue and glue it down. Right. Here, like this. And you can then put around some embellishments, some signs, some notes. I think like this it is. Let it dry. Good. On that opposite side, I would like to have, I think on this opposite side, I would like to have pocket with two tacks. So I'm gonna prepare that pocket. I'm gonna find some cardstock which will matching beautifully with this one. And because here I choose this paper, I'm gonna choose again this paper. It's from my Mind's Eye collection, Lost and Found. This ruby. It's a ruby collection. It's a really gorgeous, very beautiful collection full of beautiful papers. I will prepare some journals from this one as well because I love that. I love this one. So I'm gonna choose again this paper. Here I will cut strip of paper. This is 3 and 3.5 inch. Yes, it's 3.5 inch wide and 6 inches tall. So I'm gonna cut strip of paper because I wanna have pocket from here to here, and I think just 1 inch less. So I'm gonna cut strip of paper 2.5 wide and 7 inches tall. I did cut paper not 2.5 but 3 by 7, 3 inches, 7 inches, and now I'm gonna make score lines. 1/2 inch here on that long side and 1/2 inches on these short sides. One here and one here. And it gave me 2.5 by 6 inch pocket. I'm gonna cut these edges like this. Here is score line. I hope you can see that. Here is score line. So I'm gonna cut out this one. These corners. Like this. Fold it. Like is that score line. Fold it. And I will have here pocket from side to side like this. Yeah, that will be good. And because I would like to have there those like half circle cuts, I'm gonna fold it like this. I'm gonna take my circle punch, I'm gonna try to put it in the middle of that paper, and I don't mind too much that I will have small fold in the middle, because in the middle then I will put the glue. So here I've got, I can see the line when I fold it, so I will put glue there and also on these edges, and then I will have like two pockets. I'm gonna distress it and I'm gonna show you. I distress all edges. Now I'm going to put glue here on these fold sides, fold flops, and also in the middle where I can see that folded line, just a little bit, not too much. And I'm gonna glue it down. Oops, oops, la. My pin just fall down. I will have to find it, other way I will step on it. I know myself. I'm gonna glue it down like this. And we've got nice, beautiful double pocket for tucks. Which has loads of space. And we've got our pocket for our tacks. Here I'm using, this is dye from Tonic Studio. It's Love from Tag Dye Set. It looks like this. I'm gonna take it off from that pocket. This way. Oops. It's these dies. This tag, circle, it can be I've got here magnetic wall where I've got all my favorite dies, so that's why I'm not have them in those packages. That's why for a few of my dies, many of my dies, I even don't keep those packages, so I don't remember where from I've got them, but this one I kept, luckily I kept. So this is Tonic Studio Love Dies. Here you've got name, Love from Tag Die Set, and it's these dies. So you can cut tag, you can cut circle with those beautiful hearts, you can cut even, it's not circle, it's oval, and you can cut love from, it looks like this. And those eyelets are from Abbey Tops, those eyelets with washers, 8mm antique copper. It's these I used here. They've got from that opposite side, they've got small circles, so it holding properly, it looks nice from both sides. And tool I'm using, it's this one, eyelet setting tool, and I can't say this one, I have no idea how to say that properly, so I'm not gonna say that. I'm gonna show you what is it. It's a very noisy tool, you have to use hammer. You put eyelet here, place it here, you put that what is it, washer piece here, put inside this and hammer until it's holding together. I'm not gonna show you how it works because it's too noisy. My dog always running out when I'm using this tool. So I'm using this one. So what we've got so far, we've got frame here. I think I will embellish that a little bit all around. We've got pockets for tags here. We've got closure and pocket here. Pocket here, pocket here, and top cover. So we're gonna create something here, and I already prepared a little bit, few pieces. I would like to have there, again, magnetic closure using some dye. So what I did, I took two similar dies. I glued magnet inside between them, and here I've got that another magnet. Here you can see in one that mint, Here it's magnet glued between two dies. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna put my die on my paper. This I prepared before. I've got this beautiful ephemera. So I glue it on coffee dyed paper. I folded that paper and then I cut around with this tab that paper. So I've got like a small booklet. I'm gonna put the die on the top, that magnet. I'm gonna put on the bottom. And here I would like to have that magnetic closure where the mints will be glued on this top page. And they will like hold everything inside with that magnet. So that's why I place it here. Now I can manage these mints. I think I will glue that paper this way. So I can manage these mints where I want them. If I want them hung like this and have that closure just right here, or I would like to have them a little bit down, and I think it will be this way, like this, I think. Yes, then I know I'm gonna flip it over. I'm gonna put my glue. Oops. Here, around that magnet, all over. I'm gonna put that glue. I can put a little bit of glue on that magnet, but I'm not gonna use this tacky glue. That's the ugly pieces again. I'm gonna use this Uhu glue, which needs to dry a little bit, so I should place it like my first glue. Oh wow. Okay, not gonna let dry because the tacky glue is drying so fast. So I'm gonna flip it over and I'm gonna glue down this piece which will glued down. Oh my, I'm sorry for my English today. I think it's too late. So I can't even speak properly. It will glue down also the magnet underneath. So I've got writing space. And I will have my closure. Now I will create something on the top. And I forgot to prepare something. So what I'm gonna do. This I would like to have probably inside. Like this. Probably not. Okay. So I think I'm gonna use this piece. Here, it's too big. It can be a little bit down. Okay, but I'm gonna choose some image. I think I've got beautiful photographies, winter photographies. So I will have a look and I will come back. I did choose this beautiful picture of kids. It's English winter picture, vintage. I think even Preston shared this picture 2 years ago and I totally fell in love with this. It's amazing picture. I used one of these dies. I think it's Sizzix stainless decorative labels. I've got six of them. 1, 2, 3, 6. Yeah, six of them. If I didn't lost any, there is six of them. This is smaller. This is the biggest. I've got them on that magnetic wall here as well. So I use the die and I'm gonna glue it down this like it is. And I'm gonna show you if you will put there some. You can make it also like a pocket, but I think this time I will make just writing spaces, not too many pockets here. I'm gonna glue it down here. And now, here I will put later some decoration. I'm not sure what I will put there later, but I was thinking maybe sometimes we forgot to put some closure for our pockets, for our pages. So what you can do, this is from collection from Tim Holtz Bix dies. I really love to use those big dies because you can cut out any kind of material. Really strong dies these. So I'm using this one, this top, or I'm not sure what is it, and also this, I think this is a label or holder, who knows. What is it? There is somewhere. Oh, tops and tucks. Okay, so I'm gonna using this tuck and this top for my closure. I've got here this one. Then I need to place that top where I would like to have to fix it. I'm gonna make a hole through it somehow. I don't have here that my tool, so hopefully it will be okay, because without my proper tool I'm kind of crazy. Now I'm gonna take one brat, this bronze brat. I will a little bit distress the top with, I'm using vintage photo for inside of my journal, but for outside, for that cover, I used I think it's espresso, because that cover, those colors was too dark and it didn't show up properly, that vintage photo distress ink. So I used that ground espresso for outside of my journal. Now I'm gonna, I lost it. Oh, it's here. Oops, it surprised me. I'm gonna fix my tuck inside like this. So it's, when you forget to put their closure, or you don't have enough space like I don't have here, what you can do, how you can extend your page and how you can add the closure where you need it. I'm gonna glue this top together like this. Oh, I think I made it too tight. I'm gonna. Oh, you got balloon. Where is your ball? You have a ball, I see. My son, my dog, is just behind me. He's getting bored and he bring his ball. I think he wants to play. So I glue it like this. I'm gonna let it dry. You've got glue everywhere. And now what you need to do to glue it just right next to your paper. So I'm gonna put there a little bit of glue. When you are doing something like this, make sure you can close your pages after that, okay? That it's not on the way to close your journal properly if you are doing some extension like this. And now I can slide this here nicely without any struggle. I can still close my page because this is 3.5 and this is 4 inches deep. So still I've got here 1/2 inch gap, and this tab can fit here properly. So I've got closure for my journaling space like this. Now I can glue down this mint using this bowl. So I'm gonna put a little bit of glue on this bowl of my mint. I think it's called mint. If I'm using some wrong word for that, I'm so sorry. Gloves. I'm gonna place them here. Where is that magnet? Here. Got it. And glue it down. And you've got closure here, magnetic closure for that top. So you can continue. Don't forget, you glue it here, magnet it here. Now I wanted to do, you know, opening here. No. Here is opening and we can continue. Here I've got, I don't remember where from I've got these dies. It's like a Bethlehem. So I'm gonna make small pocket here. And here I need to use some different glue. I'm gonna use glossy accent for this one because I've got that acetate piece here, and I found that if I put there a little bit of glossy accent, it holds better. I'm not gonna put too much here on that eye because I want to have that eye to peek out from my top page to make sure that I can hang something on it. So I'm gonna put glue there and also on one side here. not glue glossy accent, but it's glossy accent, it's gluing also. I'm gonna place it right here, so when it will dry, it will make nice pocket for small teeny mini tuck from here. I'm gonna let it dry, and later on I can use this eye for hanging something, you know, like eye for some charm. So we've got this one here. What I'm gonna do here, I have no idea, I will have to think. So for this side, I decide to do two pockets. I could two strips of papers, they was totally same. It was at the start, it was, I'm gonna do it in inches, 4.5 by 3.5 inches, 4.5 by 3.5. I made score lines 1/2 inch from both sides on both of them. Then I fold these lines. Here I used again that corner punch, and I cut these corners. This will be like my bottom pocket here. That second I left, it's I think 1 1/4 inch deep edges. I cut them from both sides, same 1 1/4 inch, and then I made a shape a little bit angle, not straight away, but a little bit angle, because then I would like to slide this inside, and these will stop me exactly at the same position, so I will have two pockets here. I used embossing folders. Unfortunately, I don't remember. I think these two I purchased on Everycraft's Pounds, but as I was very bad in organizing, I put them to same drawer without any cover, so I don't remember. I think this one, it's name of company, I'm not sure, by Heltz Kapelditsch, I'm not sure if you can see that, by maybe like this, Heltz Kapelditsch. And this one I think I found on eBay, but I'm not sure really. I'm not sure, I'm sorry, I can't tell you companies. But I use these three folders, these two for pockets here, and this one, it will be for closure here. I will show you as well, and then I think I will finish my video, because my camera just started shining on me that battery is getting low. So I'm gonna show you what you can do with these. I will need to small double-sided tape for here. I've got this, I think 1/4 inch double-sided tape. I'm gonna place it here on one pocket, and on that another one as well. So this side is 3.5 inch. I cut piece 4.5, and I've got 1/2 inch fold here, which means I've got 3.5 inch pocket. And this is, I think I said 3.5 inches. Now I'm going to take off that strip of paper from my double-sided tape here. I'm gonna put glue on these sides, and I'm gonna glue this first pocket first. I'm gonna glue this first pocket first to make sure I can fold it then this side inside like this. Now I'm gonna take here this paper, come on, not with tape, just paper. I'm gonna put glue here, and why I'm using here double-sided tape, because I found myself to mess inside of my pockets if I put here liquid glue, and then I'm trying to slide it in, that liquid glue, it's messing all that space inside. So here I've got just double-sided tape, and I'm gonna slide it in, just hold your first pocket a little bit up, slide this in. It will stop you, those folds, side folds will stop you on right position, and glue it down, and then somewhere here it's probably end of that pocket. And we've got two pockets. I don't have any tack, so I've got strip of paper here. We've got one pocket here, another pocket here. Here I don't know, so I'm gonna let it go for now. I'm gonna leave it like it is. I'm gonna show you this side. Here I would like to make that like coin envelope, or I don't remember name of that envelope, proper name of that envelope, but you will know what I mean. And how you can make it when both sides are totally similar and they are not even covering one or of each other. You need to extend one, and you can extend bottom with using some label. Here I'm using that third embossing folder, it's this one. I'm using here, and also I'm using dies. These are again Tonic Studio dies. Tonic Studio dies. And this is collection Gift of Love die set. Oh, it's name here. Oh my. Gift of Love. It's these three dies, two labels, one bigger, one smaller, and the Gift of Love, this. And I pre-cut the top. You can extend it from the bottom, just place it here, and then this will be like closure, this will be like pocket. Glue it down, and this will be like closure. Or you can extend the closure, and I'm gonna extend closure. So I cut the top, I cut a little bit bigger. So you can see I use that bigger die for my top cover, and here from the bottom then I will cover it like this, so it will make also frame around. So I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna glue these strips of paper for my bottom pocket. It's just 1 inch deep. I fold it half. It's from Book Pages. I fold it half. Here I cut a small notch. I'm gonna glue them to my pocket. I'm not gonna glue to the pocket yet. So I'm gonna prepare my pocket. Here. And on that. Oops, come here. On that other side. And this video is too long. I'm so sorry. I'm too slow, I think. But I hope you will find inspiration. So this will be like my pocket. I'm not gonna glue it yet because I would like to use those eyelets for my closure. So now I will have to extend the top cover of my pocket first. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna glue down this piece first where I want it, and I want to cover these corners. So I'm gonna put glue here. Not from on all sides, because it's a little bit bigger. And I think I'm gonna position it from here. Make sure I've got it somehow good. I think like this, those sides look similar. Hopefully. Like this. And because if I will leave here those edges, I will have problem to close it. So I have to cut it out. So I'm gonna cut these edges. Like this. And how I will cut it here, I have no idea. I will try. Got big scissors, small hound. Ah, this way. I can still fold it. Come on. Do not disturb me. Yes. Like this. Oh. So we've got or extended closure. I'm gonna distress those edges a little bit. I'm gonna glue down also this inside paper. Now I can put paper on all edges here. Make sure everything will be held properly. Like this, I guess, from side to side. Like this. And now we will put eyelets inside. Before you will glue down your bottom pocket. Oh, come on. It's good to find a middle. Close it, so then you know. I think I will place it like this. I guess so, because my tool, it's very noisy. I'm using these Fiskars, I believe they are Fiskars. Yes, Fiskars, these eyelets tools, it's like hammer. So I have to use my cutting plate, kitchen cutting plate. And I'm gonna make holes first on this cover. I'm gonna discover this cover. I think somewhere here, it's a middle. So I'm gonna make a hole through all these layers. Here you can see I a little bit destroy my tool. You don't have to put it to the bin. You just need, if something like this happened to you, you just need to use your hammer. And then put the right end. This is for cutting, this is for fixing eyelets. So then put right end where you need it, and hammer, and it will make hole through anything you want. So I'm gonna do it, it's noisy, so I'm gonna pause my video. I made hole through all these layers. Now what you have to do, put the trim or thread, what you want to use, like your closure, inside that hole. Take the eyelet, put it to that circle, place it inside that hole and fix it, and it will you will have a little bit from this side, but you can cut it later on. Okay, I fixed that top part. Here I'm using this bone folder to lift up a little bit that circle like this, so then it's much more easy to go around. Now I'm gonna, here you can glue it down and then fix that eyelet through. I'm gonna, I think, put it here. I'm gonna glue it down just in the middle. Put a little bit of glue to the middle. I can't see now. I did have a look to the lights around me and now I've got white spots everywhere. I hope I'm right, because now I can't see. Okay, I'm gonna put eyelet inside and I will be back. I fixed that bottom. I think it moved a little bit. Hopefully it will be not too much. Again, I'm gonna lift it a little bit to make space for the thread. Hopefully. Oh my, it's on the side a little bit. And now it will be closure like this. So I can glue down my pocket where I prepared before those pieces from old book. And we will have our pocket. Easy, right? It's noisy, but it's easy. And we've got our pocket. We can put some ephemeras, photographies, notes inside. You can close it like this. Now I'm going to cut my trim, because now I know how long I need. I should go a little bit more with the bone folder. Ah, it will work. I think I'm going like this. Here I will make some embellishment. So we've got our pocket, and I prepared small notebook for this. This is top with pocket here. It has again decorative papers, stamping papers, those beautiful images, and it has large side here. So I'm gonna put glue here. So yeah, I will have also large pocket here, and that will be all for today, because I've been silly and I did have a look to those lights around me, those lamps, and really I've got white spots everywhere. I'm trying to have a look and it's not going out, so I think I will need to finish now. My eyes are tired. I'm gonna glue it right here. Those other pages here, I will need to put some embellishment. Also, I can make... Not here. I will put some embellishment here. Tags. All kind of stuff. Oh. But we made our journal. And you can also... It's like this. So put some charms, embellishments, ephemeras. You can also make small pocket on that backside where I've got the... Bear with me. Here in this journal, I made pocket also on that backside. So you can make pocket also on that backside. So this is my small sharing for today. Oh no, it's not. I will forget again. Oh my. I told you twice already about my new tools for stamping. So very quickly, I have to share because I'm so satisfied. Yay! I've got Tonic Studio Tim Holtz stamping platform. I choose this one for many reasons. I am a huge fan of Tim Holtz because all kind of tools I've got here. Dies, embossing folders, embossing powders, inks, all kind of stuff, stamps I've got here. They are brilliant quality. I've got so many from Tonic Studio. I had Tonic Studio trimmer. I've got it again here. And I'm very satisfied with it. I've got before with that orange color. And that was brilliant. So I'm very happy from this one. And because I had great experiences with Tonic Studio. And I always having great experiences with Tim Holtz. I choose this platform. That was one reason. Another reason for buying this one. It was because it's nice size. It's 8 by 8 inches. And when I have a look on sizes of other platforms, they was much more expensive than is this one. And this platform, it's just awesome. I was thinking when I will have that time, when I will don't want to create journal, but I will want to create maybe prepared tags or, you know, some decorative papers and stamp them, I can place more than one here, more tags here, and stamp them at once. It will make my preparing for journals much more faster. And with all tools from Tim Holtz, I was always happy, and I am with this one as well. It makes my stamping much more nicer, much more beautiful. I can stamp many times if I don't put so much ink on that stamp. I can, you know, stamp many times. It's brilliant tool. And there is so many ladies who are making tutorials with stamp platforms. I like to watch Jennifer McGuire. She's amazing with her stamping. I just see spider right there. Oh my god, I'm so scared of spiders. He's small, but he's right there in front of me. Okay, I'm gonna finish and run out. I love to watch Jennifer McGuire. She's really amazing. She's using Misty platform. That was too much. In this size, that Misty platform cost triple price of then it's Tim Holtz. And I have to say this platform is amazing, really. So this is my new stamping tool. And if you forgive me, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna switch off my camera because I'm gonna run out. The spider is there. I'm gonna run for my
lot, and he will have to somehow sort it out. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. I do appreciate everything, your support. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day, and I'm gonna run out for my son. He have to deal with that spider. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.